Dumb Sports Talk, worldwide, with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now the name is Zizekat Sorumpasai. We had him. We're going to cut it down to Sorumpasai, right? Hey, you know, super flyweight champion. He beat your boy Ron Francisco Estrada with a majority decision. And it was a close fight. But I do think that Sorumpasai won this fight. He was the bigger fighter, the harder puncher. But your boy Estrada showed what counterpunching and heart can do in a fight like this. And so it was a good fight the whole way through. Good fight. Real good fight. You know, I don't really like watching the guys that are real small. But this was a good one. And Sorumpasai is known because he's the guy who beat Chocolito. And that brings us to the five reasons I think this fight was good for boxing, right? Good for boxing. Things that I noticed when I watched it. First thing that hit me, right, is something that don't even have to do with this fight. You know, Andre Ward was also calling this fight with your boy Jim Lampley and my boy, I think his name right now, the main, but Max Kellerman, right? So he's calling the fight. And so because, you know, they were promoting the fight that's coming up with Bivol and against Barrera in the light heavyweight division, they had to give Ward props for beating Barrera, because you just have to, because Barrera beat Shabransky, right, who Kovalev just beat, and Shabransky was undefeated at that time, and he beat Joe Smith. This is after losing to Ward. Ward had beat an undefeated son of Barrera, an undefeated Cuban fighter, and we didn't know why he didn't get much love and much props for that. But to promote this fight, you have to say what Ward done against a fighter of this caliber, because Barrera hasn't lost since that fight and has fought great opposition. So that was good to just hear that, because you got to. There's no way around it. So I thought that was one reason that this fight was good, right? Another thing that was good is to hear comments that are said on national TV that they think that nobody heard. Now here's something. Now check this out, you guys. About, what, 8 months ago, a year, Roman Chocolatito was put at number one pound for pound. I'm not saying top 10. Number one pound for pound. Above fighters like Andre Ward, Terrence Crawford, Vasily Lomachenko, Gennady Golovkin, and the rest. Right? He was good. He was undefeated at the time in those lower weights. A 112 weight division, 108, 112, then went to 115. Well, he was undefeated when he lost to this guy, Sorumpasai. Right? In a close fight that the people thought maybe that Chocolito might have won that fight, even though he was down in that fight. Right? Chocolito was down. So it was controversial. Right? So they have another fight. Well, one of these guys, Max Kellerman is the one I think it was, or Jim Lampley, one of them, said that Chocolito was a shot fighter by the time they had that second fight with Sorumpasai. But that's a ridiculous statement to make. He's number one pound for pound, undefeated, and has a close fight, a split decision loss, and he's shot because Sorumpasai was supposed to fight him. That makes absolutely no sense at all. You can't go from the best fighter on the planet and having a close fight to being shot. Shot would mean being knocked out three or four times or something like that, like Amir Khan or something, and he's not even shot. So a fighter with a close fight can't go from the best of all of boxing to being shot. And sometimes we say those things to diminish the fighter that we're trying to talk about right now. So I just thought that just stood out. Like, so when he said that, my face got ugly. Like, what? Did you just say that on TV? Whoa. You know, just because you got a voice and it sounds like you know what you're talking about, and we consider that you do, that is not a very smart statement to make. Because I don't think the drop is that far. Now, I know boxing, we disparage fighters all the time, but that was a little radical, from going from the best pound-for-pound fighter to shot because you had a close fight. I don't think so. That was two things that I thought was very good, because I like people to make some ridiculous statements like that on national TV. Now, another good thing I thought about this was Estrada. Estrada was obviously the smaller fighter, right? Coming up from the flyweight division, doing a good job. He beat Quadras. But, you know, he was obviously smaller, and he wasn't the harder puncher here. Rumpasai is definitely the harder puncher, but he was able to counterpunch counterpunch his way into a good fight and get in when he had to. Now, here's the thing. I think that's great when a smaller fighter is able to do that. That would encourage other fighters that are smaller to get in these fights and show what they can do against these heavier punchers. So it showed in this fight that it is possible. So this is one for the little guys, for Estrada. That's the third reason. The fourth reason, I would say, is because it's another fight that I've watched where the loser of that fight, his stock rises. Estrada looked great in that fight. He can be calling for a rematch already. He can. He's right in that little triangle of him, Rungvisai, and Quadras, because he has a win over Quadras and a close fight against Rungvisai. So he's right in there. His stock rises even though he lost. And it was similar to Canelo Alvarez against Gennady Golovkin. Great fight, great defensive fight, but you didn't do enough to win. Right? I didn't think that your boy Estrada did enough to win. He did enough to have a good fight, but not enough to win. Also similar to Huey Fury and your boy Joseph Parker in the heavyweights. Huey Fury made a good account of himself, but not enough to win. And I think the judges got this right. But these are the fights that we're talking about. Close fights, and you can have another one. That's why we're trying to encourage our heavyweights to fight each other. It's not a bad thing. It's not the end of the world if you lose a fight. You can come back. And this is a fight that's good for those kind of things. Right? That's four reasons. Fifth reason is simply Rungvisai is the truth. Period. He's the truth. He's been in close fights. He's handling his business against all the fighters. And he's the truth. And now we got some action down there because they can have a rematch against him. Or Rungvisai can also rematch Quadras. So there's fights there, even in these small divisions. And it was super fly too. And that's what I'm talking about. It was a pretty good fight and a pretty good night. So Thor Rungvisai is still super flyweight champion. And he's got a pretty good future ahead of him. Dome Sports Talk Worldwide. And I'm about to hear y'all.